program today. Greetings from me and warm welcome from Potwar Association. My name is Chanchal Singh Chowdhury and I'm the General Secretary here of the Potwar Association. Those who do not know are familiar with Potohar. Potohar was a part of British India and now in Pakistan. The Potohar region is known for its valor and many other things. And the inhabitants of Potohar are known as Potoharis. This is a land where the Vedas were written, and it's known for its diversity and a rich heritage. We are proud of its history and heritage. The most famous Potohari in the 20th century was Flight Lieutenant Hardit Singh Malik, who flown many combat missions in 1917 over Italy and France. He later on became Prime Minister of Princely State Patiala, and then he was ambassador to Canada and France. And 21st century, and I think history is yet to be written. Another person we have here tonight who's we're giving tribute to is one of our 21st century hero, Mr. B.M. Singh. Tonight, we are commemorating two things. One is inaugural lecture on Master Tara Singh, who is a legendary leader of freedom struggle in India. And the second one is Mr. B.M. Singh, who sadly left us in February earlier this year. Commemorating the life of two these gentlemen is just paying our debt to them. I will now request Lord Suri and Mr. B.M. Singh's grandson, Inder Neel, please come and unveil the portrait of Mr. B.M. Singh. Thank you. Once they have unveiled the portrait, I will request all of you, please stand up for 1 minute of silence, please, after it's been. For the benefit of those who do not know Mr. B.M. Singh, he was larger than life character who was a prime example of hard work and success that we have come to associate with Potoharis. We are proud of what he has done and achieved. For more about Mr. B.M. Singh, may I request once again Lord Suri to come and say a few words about him. Lord Suri has spent time with him both in Africa, and I think he's a contemporary of Mr. B.M. Singh from his days in color when Papaji was in Rawalpindi. Thank you.
Fellow member of Lords, Lord Nuba, and Siddhartha Lochan Singh Ji, who is ex-MP in India, or which is Raj Sabha of India, which is equal to the House of Lords here. And Mr. Sharma, the Member of Parliament, and other respective guests, ladies and gentlemen. I will take the pleasure of saying a few words about B.M. Singh Ji, whose name was Bal Mahinder Singh or Bal Mahinder Singh. I can define both the names, but some other times. But he was known as a B.M. Singh. Bal Mahinder Singh Ji was born in Kallar on 10th January 1927. He was an honest and a God-fearing man. He respected all and was respected by all. He had no enemies and was friend of everyone in his contacts. He can be described, as Gurbani says, na ko bari, na hi begana, sagal sang hamko banayai. I met him first time in Nairobi in 1949 when he was getting married, and I attended the marriage ceremony. In those days, in East Africa, even in India as well, marriage was taking place at their homes. But in this case, the brat was received at home of Papaji Sardara Singh Ji, and marriage took place in the Gurdwara. His arrival in East Africa was organized by his Jijaji, Sardar Madan Singh, who was a high-ranking police officer for a long time. He was first Asian who was appointed commissioner of policemen of a police, and he attended his new appointment ceremony held in London. When he arrived back from London by sea and stayed at Mombasa with our families, and he brought a press cutting from Britain. I think it was sometimes late 1950. The press, which was the press cutting, was from either Times or Telegraph, and which I read myself because I was a student at that time. But it was a proud and pride for everyone over there. And the press short note was written: An Indian native, Mr. Madan Singh, has been appointed Commissioner of Police for Tanzania. He was a decent man. When he expired, Sardar Madan Singh Ji, and Mr. B.M. Singh Ji asked me to say few words on his pogue ceremony. My key words for his tribute was, being lifetime policeman, he had no blots on him, or he has not, or do not, did not have any wrongdoings record. He went like a clean and spotless white sheet. Mr. B.M. Singh Ji, he was Gurbani, and with Guru Kar was very much attached. He used to have Maharaj Prakash at his home, both homes which I saw here in London. One was Bushi and one was the current one. And he had the honor with the company of Sant Mahatma and Ragi Vigara. I remember one Sant Ji who has built two Gurdwaras in South Hall. I think his name is Jagjit Singh. Jaswant Singh, that's right, yes. Whom I met personally, because he originally built a hospital, Guru Tegh Bahadur Hospital in Ludhiana, where I also played a little role when I came here by collecting charity for it. And he completed the building, and then government of Punjab gave him some more land to build schools. And here in London, in South Hall, he built two schools. He was also very much interested in music, kavita, and other Punjabi, the Has Ras Diyan Kavitawan. He especially used to remember some wordings, always used to, when we were having a relaxed time, a Has Ras, I think Sathi Saab may be knowing, Paiya Ishar Singh Ishar. Yes. All his books were written as a humorous.
That's right.
And the few lines which he will remember, he will laugh, and we will all enjoy. I'll read that in Punjabi. And especially, he used to sing that thing or remember after the partition, because that was the sort of a curse of partition. He wrote, Paiyaji, koi jamya pindi, koi jamya Lahore, main Gujar Khan jamya. why he wrote Gujar Khan was a subsection Tahsil, which was much connected with Kohat. And where B.M. Singh was born, he was in that Kohat area. Anji. मैं जमिया पिंडी कोई जमिया पिंडी कोई जमिया लाहौर मैं गुजर खान जमिया हाँ कोई जमिया विच हस्पताल कोई जमिया विच डिस्पेंसरी हाँ मैं रड़े मैदान जमिया ते एंड दे जड़ा के एब्सोल्यूट पार्टीशन दे पर एंड ठोके दिल दी आवाज़ कहंदा कोई खांदा रोटी कोई खांदा डबल रोटी मैं तक्के खान जमया सी ही वाज दैट सॉर्ट ऑफ पर्सन के दिल दिया गला मतलब के आंदियां सन सो ही डिड दैट ही वाज ए वेरी गुड फैमिली मैन ए डिवोटेड हस्बैंड एंड केयरिंग हस्बैंड ए डिवोटेड फादर फादर इन लॉ ग्रैंडफादर एंड ग्रेट ग्रैंडफादर एज वेल. At the end, I will just pray to Almighty Vaheguru, ke Vaheguru, sari Singh family nu chardi kala vich rakhe, ate Singh family da jo hotel da je empire hai, jeda ke is vele takriban 2 billion de ratio te ja reha hai, unna de sputr leader of leadership, under the leadership of Jasminder, ਇਹ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਝੱਡੀ ਕਲਾ 'ਚ ਰਵੇ. ਵਿਦ ਦਿਸ ਫਿਊ ਵਰਡਸ ਆਈ ਟੇਕ ਇਟ. ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਵੈਰੀ ਮਚ.
ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਲਾਰਡ ਸੂਰੀ, ਥੈਂਕਸ ਵੈਰੀ ਮਚ ਫੋਰ ਦ ਇਨਸਾਈਡ ਇਨ ਟੂ ਦ ਲਾਈਫ ਵਿਚ ਵਾਸ ਰੈਲੇਟਿਵਲੀ ਅਨਨੋਨ ਟੂ ਅਸ. ਆਈ ਮਸਟ ਐਡ ਵੇਅਰ ਵੀ ਸਿਟਿੰਗ ਟੂ ਨਾਈਟ ਇਜ਼ ਦ ਵਨ ਆਫ ਦੇਅਰ ਫਲੈਗਸ਼ਿਪ ਹੋਟੇਲ ਐਂਡ all the expenses are paid by themselves, and it's a complimentary to us, and we just thank you, a big thank you. Now I'll ask Vani Chowdhury and Donia Soni to come and compare the rest of the evening. Thank you. Please welcome Vani and Donia.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's lovely to see so many of you taking time out of your busy schedule to come and celebrate the life of Master Tara Singh with us this evening. We have a great few events ahead of us, so please enjoy. I'm Vani Chowdhury.
Hi, and I'm Donia Soni. First of all, we'd like to invite the president of the Potohar Association. He has been in the Potohar community for a long time and has aided in many different roles. So ladies and gentlemen, please give a big round of applause to Mr. Pushpinder Singh Khanpur.
Respected Chief Guest, Sardar Talochan Singh Ji, Honorable Member of Parliament, Virendra Sharma, distinguished guests, my lords, ladies, and gentlemen. Lord Lumba is missing, I think. Anyway, might be outside. My lord, ladies, and gentlemen, on behalf of the Potohar Association, I'm delighted and honored to extend a hearty welcome to you all here tonight to this inaugural Master Tara Singh Memorial Lecture. It's part of the number of new initiatives which the incumbent executive committee has taken. The Potohar Association, for some people I must say a few words about Potohar Association, some people don't know about it, founded in 1970, is a community organization with cohesive vision, aspiring unity in diversity, and we endeavor to uphold the ethics of our culture and heritage, which give us strength to looking after the interests and well-being of our elderly and the youth alike. We all work in a friendly environment in unison, harmony, and respect for each other, very important. We are fortunate to be part of our brotherhood to stay connected with our roots, which is also very important. Today is our inaugural annual lecture. We'll be having every year almost, with an overview on the life and achievement of Master Tara Singh, as you know, also a Potwari, who was a Potwari, an extraordinary leader who is equally responsible for getting our fair share in the independent India. To reiterate his standing as our father of nation in Punjab, I would call him that, would only do justice to his whole life he gave to this cause. We could not have a better judge than Sardar Tarlochan Singh Ji, traveling from India today to enlighten us on the subject. Thank you, sir, for being here. As mentioned, we want to preserve our heritage. Next year is going to be an exciting landmark as we celebrate 100 years of Potwaris in Britain. During the celebratory year, we want to see contributions of Potwaris in the UK and also, additionally, both First and Second World Wars. I'm also aware of the importance of getting our youth involved in such cultural activities. Tonight, we will honor a few of them with Pride of Potohar Award, which is designated after our prominent Potohari, late Sardar Balminder Singh Ji. We are achieving and making progress through hard work, cooperation, sincerity. I take this opportunity to extend my sincere thanks to all supporters, donors, patrons, advisors, and our membership, and the executive committee, who always contribute physically as well as financially. I am pleased to say that we are also celebrating life and times of Mr. Balminder Singh Ji. A very special gratitude from bottom of our hearts to Mr. Jasminder Singh Ji, MD of Edwardian Group of Hotels, and his family, his son, Mr. Indraneel Singh, grandson of late Mr. B.M. Singh, for their kind generosity and support for the event today and in the future. Papa Ji, as we all knew him, Sardar B.M. Singh always wanted to see this Biradari to achieve new heights, always talked about it. I only reiterate and endorse what Lord Suri has already told you about him and appreciate what he said. Our sincere thanks to Vora family and Mrs. Jasbir Vora, wife of late Mr. Kogi Vora. I can't help mentioning him always. He was a good friend who have always been on our side with their everlasting support for the brotherhood. Thank you. Finally, I believe there is still a lot to be done, and God willing, we shall accomplish our goals to provide our aims and objectives, including buying a suitable premises for the association sooner than later. We will appreciate your generosity if you come forward to help and support us, and for this purpose, please get in touch with us today, and we can happily get you involved in supporting us. We need funds for the brotherhood. Anyway, you know we need funds for the building. My best wishes to you all for coming here, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you. God bless you all.
Thank you very much. Now we'd like to invite Dr. Sathi Singh Ludhianvi, who is an accomplished author and renowned journalist. He is a presenter and producer on Asian Star Radio and MATV Television.
The Potohar Association has asked him to write a poem specially for this evening, and he has kindly obliged. Please join us in welcoming him to the stage to share his warm words on Master Thara Singh.
Lord Lumbaji, is he there? I think I saw you were there. And Birendra Sharma ji, Honorable Birendra Sharma ji, Lord Suri ji, Mr. Trilochan Singh ji, Honorable Trilochan Singh ji, who is the former a member of Rajya Sabha in India, and he is also an ex-MP and chairman of Minority Commission, and he will share the insights of Master Thara Singh. I have written a poem about Master Thara Singh, which I will recite in a minute. But before I do that, actually, when I saw B.M. Singh's picture there, I had fond memory of that great man. I think in the 70s, when he came from East Africa, he bought a post office, sub post office, and I trained him. Can you believe it? I trained his wife and his daughter, I forgot her name. And it was a pleasure, actually a real pleasure, to meet that family and to be associated with that family. I was the training officer from the post office, and they will always say, look, I know you are given the money to eat your lunch somewhere, but it'll be a real pleasure if you eat with us every day, which I did. I pay tribute to B.M. Singh. It was a pleasure to know him and his family. Master Thara Singh, he was from Potohar area of India at that time. And being a writer and a poet, a little bit what I am, I have fond memories meeting Kartar Singh Duggal. I never met Bhai Veer Singh. I saw him on the stage only. I never talked to him. He was such a great man. And then we had Professor Mohan Singh. He was a very, if somebody asks you who were the great Punjabi poets, most of the people say Shiv Kumar Batalvi, Amartya Pritam, and Mohan Singh. If I answer that question, Shiv Kumar Batalvi was Birhada Sultan. Nobody can beat him. But Professor Mohan Singh, he was a versatile poet. Or he could write on anything. If you can remember, 1969 was the 500th birthday of Guru Nanak Dev Ji, and he wrote this epic called Nankain. So Potohar, area of Potohar, they have produced sons and daughters who are stars of history. And Master Thara Singh was, of course, one of them. And Siddharth Lojan Singh Ji, he will talk about Master Thara Singh, but being a poet, I will talk about Master Thara Singh in my poem. Because of the shortage of time, I will not go into much detail. Let's have that poem. Leader, ek mahan son, Master Thara Singh. Leader, ek mahan son, Master Thara Singh. Panth di ta shan son, Master Thara Singh. Thonu pata na panth ratan vi kehnde si unna nu. Ke leader, ek mahan son, Master Thara Singh. Panth di ta shan son, Master Thara Singh. To share Vrinder ji, ke unna nu panth ratan vi aakhde san lok. Unna nu panth ratan vi aakhde san lok. Panth da sanman son, Master Thara Singh. Ke haryal Potohar de son, o jampal. 1865 ਦਾ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਜਨਮ ਸੀ ਨਾ 1885 ਹਾਂਜੀ 1885 ਦਾ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਜਨਮ ਸੀ ਐਂਡ ਹੀ ਲੈਫਟ ਦਿਸ ਵਰਲਡ ਇਨ 1967 ਕਿ ਪੰਥ ਦਾ ਕਿ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਪੰਥ ਰਤਨ ਵੀ ਆਖਦੇ ਸਨ ਲੋਕ ਪੰਥ ਦਾ ਸਨਮਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ ਹਰਿਆਲ ਪੋਠੋਹਾਰ ਦੇ ਸਨ ਉਹ ਜੰਪਲ ਚਿੰਤਕ ਸਨ ਗੁਣਵਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ I was very young man when I was, I met him. I met him when I was a college student. Before that, I saw him. I didn't meet him. I saw him when I was a school student. ਹੀ ਹੈਡ ਏ ਪਰਸਨੈਲਿਟੀ ਵੈਰੀ ਮਿਕਨਾਤੀਸੀ ਜਿਹਨੂੰ ਪੰਜਾਬੀ 'ਚ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਆ, ਇਹੋ ਜਿਹੇ ਉਹ ਬੰਦੇ ਸੀਗੇ ਕਿ ਚਿੰਤਕ ਸਨ, ਹਰਿਆਲ ਪੋਠੋਹਾਰ ਦੇ ਸਨ ਉਹ ਜੰਪਲ, ਚਿੰਤਕ ਸਨ, ਗੁਣਵਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ, ਪੰਜ ਕਕਾਰਾਂ ਦੇ ਧਾਰਨੀ ਸਨ ਗੁਰੂ ਦੇ ਸਿੰਘ ਸਨ, ਪੰਜ ਕਕਾਰਾਂ ਦੇ ਧਾਰਨੀ ਸਨ ਗੁਰੂ ਦੇ ਸਿੰਘ ਸਨ, ਪਹਿਨ ਦੇ ਕਿਰਪਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ, ਕਿ ਪੰਜ ਕਕਾਰਾਂ ਦੇ ਧਾਰਨੀ ਸਨ ਗੁਰੂ ਦੇ ਸਿੰਘ ਸਨ, ਪਹਿਨ ਦੇ ਕਿਰਪਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ, ਹੈੱਡ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਸਨ, ਹੈੱਡ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਸਨ, ਹੈੱਡ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਸਨ, ਵਿੱਦਿਆ ਵੰਡਦੇ ਸਨ ਹਰ ਰੋਜ਼, ਹੈੱਡ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਸਨ, ਵਿੱਦਿਆ ਵੰਡਦੇ ਸਨ ਹਰ ਰੋਜ਼, ਬੜੇ ਤਕੜੇ ਵਿਦਵਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ, ਕੋਈ ਜੌਹਰੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਿਲਿਆ ਕਾਸ਼ ਜੋ ਕਹਿ ਸਕੇ, ਕੋਈ ਜੌਹਰੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਿਲਿਆ ਕਾਸ਼ ਜੋ ਕਹਿ ਸਕੇ, ਹੀਰਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਖਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ। ਤਾਲੀ ਵਜਾਓ। ਬਹੁਤ ਵੱਡੇ ਸਨ ਉਹ ਐਕਚੁਲੀ, ਆਈ ਕੈਨ ਟੈਲ ਯੂ ਦਿਸ, ਕਿ ਅਗਰ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਹਿਸਟਰੀ ਪੜ੍ਹੋ ਕਿ ਹੀ ਹੈਡ ਵੈਰੀ ਸੈਕੂਲਰ ਥਿੰਕਿੰਗ ਐਂਡ ਹੀ ਵਾਜ਼ ਅਗੇਂਸਟ ਕ੍ਰੀਏਸ਼ਨ ਔਫ ਪਾਕਿਸਤਾਨ। ਅੱਜ ਦਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਭਾਰਤ ਹੈ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਅਖੰਡ ਦੇਖਣਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਸਨ। ਅੱਜ ਦੇ ਦੌਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਵਰਗੇ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਲੀਡਰ ਹੈ ਉਹ ਪੰਥ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਚਾਹੀਦੇ ਨੇ ਜੋ ਕੁਛ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੋ ਰਿਹਾ, ਔਰ ਇੰਡੀਆ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਚਾਹੀਦੇ ਨੇ, ਕਿ ਕੋਈ ਜੌਹਰੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਿਲਿਆ ਕਾਸ਼ ਜੋ ਕਹਿ ਸਕੇ, ਹੀਰਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਖਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ, ਮੁਲਕ ਵੰਡ ਲਓਗੇ, ਮੁਲਕ ਵੰਡ ਲਓਗੇ, ਦਿਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਵੰਡ ਸਕਦੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ, ਮੁਲਕ ਵੰਡ ਲਓਗੇ, ਦਿਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਵੰਡ ਸਕਦੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ, ਕਰਦੇ ਇਹ ਐਲਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ। ਮੁਲਕ ਵੰਡ ਲਓਗੇ, ਦਿਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਵੰਡ ਸਕਦੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ, ਕਰਦੇ ਇਹ ਐਲਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ ਤੋਂ ਮਗਤਾ ਹੈ। ਪੰਜਾਬ ਰਹੇਗਾ ਸਾਥੀ ਅਖੰਡ ਭਾਰਤ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ, ਪੰਜਾਬ ਰਹੇਗਾ ਸਾਥੀ ਅਖੰਡ ਭਾਰਤ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ, ਏਕਤਾ ਦਾ ਅਨਵਾਨ ਸਨ ਡਾਕਟਰ ਏਕਤਾ ਦਾ ਅਨਵਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ। ਪੰਜਾਬ ਰਹੇਗਾ ਸਾਥੀ ਅਖੰਡ ਭਾਰਤ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ, ਏਕਤਾ ਦਾ ਅਨਵਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ, ਲੀਡਰ ਇੱਕ ਮਹਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ, ਪੰਥ ਦੀ ਤਾਂ ਸ਼ਾਨ ਸਨ ਮਾਸਟਰ ਤਾਰਾ ਸਿੰਘ। ਮੈਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਯਾਦ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਿਰ ਝੁਕਾਉਣਾ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਗ੍ਰੇਟਫੁਲ ਟੂ ਪੋਠੋਹਾਰ ਐਸੋਸੀਏਸ਼ਨ ਟੂ ਗਿਵ ਮੀ ਦਾ ਓਪਰਚੁਨਿਟੀ ਟੂ ਪੇ ਟ੍ਰਿਬਿਊਟ ਟੂ ਸੱਚ ਏ ਗ੍ਰੇਟ ਮੈਨ। ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਵੈਰੀ ਮੱਚ ਇੰਡੀਡ।
Sukhneel Kaur Goyal.
She is a solicitor, family law practitioner, and partner at GTP Law Firm. She is actively involved in her community and a human rights advocate. Please welcome her to the stage.
Finally, we'd like to invite Mr. Darlochan Singh on stage. Mr. Singh has an illustrious past, starting in the Punjab government, making his way all the way to the as a member of parliament.
As part of his activist work, he has been a voice for refugees from Kashmir and Afghanistan. He brings with him a wealth of experience and knowledge.
Delighted, and so is this audience, for you to have accepted our invitation to speak on the life and times of Master Tara Singh. From one Patwari to another, Sat Sri Akal and Ji Ayanu.
Thank you. Actually, I'm very happy, actually and obliged to the Potwara Session that they have provided an opportunity to me to meet all of you and to say something about a person who was responsible, a single man, bringing the border of Pakistan, which was going to be Gurgaon near Delhi, he pushed it and brought to Atari. So whole of one man's contribution that Punjab was divided. So today I'm happy that we are going to discuss this forgotten hero. I am also very happy that today gathering we have where Lord Suri, where my friend, whose father was my friend, Shri Lekhraj Ji, Vinder Sharma, MP for many terms, is here, part of you. And something more, she has mentioned, and Mr. Sathi has mentioned, and our president, about Potwar. We must always remember our heritage. Potwar heritage, one thing you must remember, Raja Porus Sabarwal was the last ruler who fought against Alexander, a Potwari. Panani, who gave algebra and grammar to the world, first word man, was from Manakiala near Rawalpindi, a Potwari. Taxila, the word university, which is now a heritage, was in Potwar. So all what you feel today, ki why so many people in Potwar are so literate, so leader, this is all Taxila's heritage, which you have, that is in Potwar. So that's what Mr. Sathi mentioned about poets. So many. General Arora, who won the Bengal War from Potwar. General Kulwant Singh from Potwar. Bhai Jodh Singh, the first principal of Khalsa College, Amritsar. Principal Teja Singh. Chief Justice Sir Teja Singh. So many, all from Potwar, who contributed. Gurmukh Singh Musafir. Two prime ministers, Dr. Manmohan Singh and Gujral from Potwar. So you have that rich heritage. It's good of you that now you have started not only remembering them, but teaching your children. So I'm happy to be here.
Well, after all those words, I think we're all feeling very proud already just sitting here. Master Thara Singh, your passion for him is well known. You had his portrait hung in the Houses of Parliament, you had a statue commissioned. What created this passion? What made you do things which hadn't been done before?
So this has been my mission, that those who did so much for the country, what country has done for them? I give credit to Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji, that he allowed me that I presented the portrait of Master Thara Singh, which he unveiled in the Parliament. So Master Thara Singh portrait was installed in Parliament. Secondly, a statue of Master Thara Singh, I worked very hard for years, ultimately allowed it is outside the Parliament, statue of Master Thara Singh. So this is my personal effort, contribution, but I'm thankful to those who helped me so that we could achieve this. But India is still, the whole nation is to repay what Master Thara Singh did, and that is the topic today, what should be done and how to be done.
Absolutely. But before we get into that, I think everybody has seen this book recently written by Sir Siddhartha Lochan Singh, and which will be available in the foyer after our evening of events. Siddhartha Lochan Singh, please tell us about your role as a member of the Rajya Sabha, as chairman of the Minorities Commission. What were you able to achieve? What legislation were you able to propose, achieve, and what influences you had on governing matters?
You see, since very seasoned parliamentarians are sitting here, and those who have established what a member parliament can do, I have been lucky in this sense that I was chairman of the National Commission for Minorities, the only non-Muslim ever. Otherwise, all chairmen have been Muslim. So I was the only one. I was member of the National Human Rights Commission of India. I was member of the Population Commission of India, member of Rajya Sabha, and so many sessions. And I, with my knowledge and Guru's blessing, whatever I could do, I have written a book, Minority Commission and the Sikhs, Minority Commission and the Christian, Minority Commission and the Muslim, what I did for minorities. Anand Marriage Act, which was a demand of the Sikhs for last 50 years, has been amended with my efforts. Now every Sikh who is now marrying as per Sikh rights, he gets a certificate of a Sikh marriage. Earlier it was all a Hindu marriage act when you get a certificate. So this is the I moved another motion to make amendment in section 25, which is the everlasting demand of the Sikhs, that section 25 does not give the Sikh as a separate dharma. We are clubbed along with Buddhist and Jaini with the Hindu. So that also I moved in the parliament, but unfortunately it could not be coming on the agenda.
Well, looking after the rights of the Sikhs and minorities, would you say following in the footsteps of Master Tara Singh?
You see, Master Tara Singh is one person who is most misunderstood, maligned, dubbed as a communalist, and even sometimes there were allegations that he sold the Sikh community and came to India because, as you are aware, Master Tara Singh was a born Hindu as Nanak Chand in village Harial, Pothwar. He baptized himself as a Sikh at the age of 12 and was done by Sant Atar Singh, the saint of at that time. And from the day he became Sikh when he was reading in missionary school, Rawalpindi, all his life, every breath, he worked for the Sikh community as a minority leader. And he did everything that minorities should get respect. So he fought for that, and before partition and after partition. After partition, his achievement, Punjabi Suba. He, from 1948 till 1966, when Punjab was divided, he fought that Sikhs should get some area where they should feel that they are in majority. But he always stood with the country. That is the main thing. Master Tara Singh went to jail as a Congress worker. He was part of the civil disobedience movement. He was one man who was member of the committee of Congress which selected Tiranga. This Tiranga, only 5 people selected, Master Tara Singh was one. So he stood by the country everywhere. But where the question of the Sikh identity, Sikh, what issue, he went all out, and he never felt shy of saying that I am a Sikh, I am a Sikh, I am a Sikh.
And all these from humble beginnings in Harial, a small village in Rawalpindi district. Tell us about his early childhood.
Robert?
About his early childhood.
You see, early, as I told you, that Pothwar, the Hindu Sikh population was 5%. We were otherwise owner of properties. The maximum property was owned by Hindu and Sikhs, but our population was 5%. So to live in that area, in each village there used to be one or two Hindu or Sikh homes. So Master Tara Singh, you see, lived like that in those villages and came up, and then after graduation from Khalsa Kaj Amritsar, at that time he could have become an ICS officer, he could have become some other officer, but he decided that I will become a teacher. He became a teacher and got only rupees 15 as pay, and then headmaster of the first school. That's why master name attached with him, because he devoted his life for service.
Yes, so learned, following the Panthic values, looking after the interests of minorities, even at that age, he came to be headmaster. And that's really when his contact with politics started, and he started being concerned of the voice of the Sikhs in the changing political climate of India at the time. He started a newspaper, didn't he, initially? Can you tell us about that?
He was a regular journalist, writer. He founded many newspapers himself, and he remained journalist till last. He was author of the books. He, the first novel, Baba Tega Singh, he wrote, then a Prem Lagan, and he was one of the best Punjabi writer in his time, and he devoted this always to educate people through his writings about history, about the current matter, and that life he continued, because perhaps most of you are aware that in Lahore, the press was vernacular press. That was all Urdu press. So he alone has to fight with them. And that he did. He also started an Urdu newspaper, Ajit, in Lahore. So he remained in his life as a good writer.
As a voice. As a voice always,
yes,
to bring the issues
out. To spread the message.
Yes. And then the Shromani Gurdwara Prabandhak Committee was created. The Akali Dal Party was formed. Please tell us of his influence on these major Sikh institutions which were established at the time so that the Sikh voice could be heard.
You see, this Gurdwara movement was one of the most, you can say, non-violence movement which took place in India when the Gurdwaras were liberated from Mahants. So this movement, Mastara Singh was a volunteer. He quoted rest many times. And when the first Gurdwara committee was formed, it's known as SGPC, he was elected the first secretary at the very young age. Because of his devotion and intelligence, the Sikhs trusted him that let him be the first person to run the Gurdwara committee. And this Gurdwara movement, for your information again, Mahatma Gandhi wrote that India's first battle has been won, and that too through non-violence. When the Akalis got the control of Gurdwara Nankana Sahib, Mahatma Gandhi himself wrote to Mastara Singh, that is your victory. And Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru came from Delhi and courted arrest in Jato Morcha along with Akali volunteers, and he remained in Nabha jail for 7 days. So Nehru and Gandhi, they themselves supported this Gurdwara movement. That is called that Mastara Singh and all leader made it a national movement.
Yes. Now, just touching on the Morcha again, for our younger listeners tonight, can you just explain what a Morcha is?
This Morcha is a Punjabi word now, which is all over India. It has been adopted by all languages. It is called when a group of people move together, march together, or sit together, and through non-violence way, they lodge protest. So this Morcha by Akalis was that the Sikh Jatha, Sikh, used to walk from Amritsar to Nankana Sahib, to Jato, to Guru Ka Bagh, and the police used to beat them, but they remain non-violent. There are still films which are shown these days, how these Morchas carried on. So these Morchas led to the success of Gurdwara movement, and ultimately SGPC was formed by the government.
That is a very important point, because Sikhs are not generally known for this, you know, in today's world, for non-violent protests. And it's very crucial, again, isn't it, that you've highlighted for us at that time, the protest was all non-violent. Sikhs were killed, they were injured, they were maimed, they were jailed. And it was leaders such as Master Thara Singh who started that. And, you know, we always hear of Mahatma Gandhi being the non-violent protester. But, you know, I mean, any more thoughts on that?
You see, what you mentioned, this violence and the non-violence movement are two different terms. Violence started in Punjab in March 1947, when the Muslim League started attacking Sikhs in Potwar, in whole of the area of Rawalpindi. In March 1947, Sikhs and Hindus were killed. That was the violence started by the Muslim League, and that was a real threat to Congress, to concede our demand, otherwise we will do like this all over India. So that was the biggest message which Mastara Singh alone faced. This is very interesting, because this is a very common talk, even today people were talking, that Punjab was a majority Muslim state. Lahore was the capital of Punjab. Khizr Ayat Khan was the chief minister, prime minister they used to call, of a coalition government. Under the pressure of Muslim League, he resigned. And the day he resigned, a new government was to take place. That was a Muslim League government. The Mastara Singh took all the Akali MLAs to Lahore Assembly. Inside, he decided, we will not allow Muslim League to form the government. Because now all of you are very intelligent people. Had there been a Muslim League government in Punjab in March 47, then they would have dictated the terms for the partition of Pakistan. So Mastara Singh thought of it. He there and then said, Pakistan Murdabad. He came out. He didn't touch any flag because there was no flag. That was British flag. That wrong impression given that Mastara Singh Talwar Nal flag cut. No. Master Ji came along with MLA shouting slogan, Pakistan Murdabad. That one incident, if you ask me, was responsible for division of Punjab, for India was saved by that one incident where Mastara Singh took courage. 10,000 Muslims were standing outside. They wanted to kill them. 10,000 Muslims garroted assembly and there were only 21 Akalis. Master took courage and he came shouting slogan, Pakistan Murdabad. Then ultimately the governor and police came and they protected them. But that incident alone, Mastara Singh wrote in his own memoir, I never took sword outside. He was totally against Nangi Talwar and never touched any flag, but I shouted slogan. So this was one man's effort against Pakistan. That's what I want to plead, that he went to sacrifice his life for this purpose, but India ignored him after independence. He was, unfortunately, the first political arrest in 1949 in India was of Mastara Singh. His contribution and what we did to him, that is shame on us.
But the divisions with, just going back a little bit, the divisions with the Congress movement started really when Master Thara Singh didn't support them in the boycott of recruiting soldiers for the British Army. So I think that's when really the divisions were beginning.
Very good question she has put.
So, can you just elaborate on...
So because we are now learning history and remembering history, you see Mastara Singh remained a congressman, member of the Congress Party till 1942. He was Akali as well as Congress. Sar Pratap Singh Kairo was his private secretary. Swaran Singh, Baldev Singh, every Sikh leader you have heard, they are all his creation. In 1942, Congress issued a boycott call of the Second World War. Gandhiji told Mastara Singh to participate in that. Masterji said that I am for the boycott of this. I am for the full independence. But I want that the Sikhs should join army. He said that I don't want that we should remain out and the Muslim army should control India. Because Muslim League was supporting the war efforts and every Muslim everywhere, the recruitment was on. So Mastara Singh said that my vision is that unless India army have more Sikh and Hindus, it will be very difficult, the type of independence, to keep us united now. So Mastara Singh fought for it, that Sikh should participate in army, and maximum Sikh went in army, and those very people became generals and later on, and our share went in. That not only helped us a political situation, but economic revolution in Punjab came, because when lakhs of Sikh went to army, and the British paid well, so that was also an economic fact. So on that day, Mastara Singh and Congress, there was break. Because Gandhiji wrote to him, that Mastara Singh decide, are you a communalist or a nationalist? Masterji replied, Gandhiji, I am a Sikh. I am Sikh and nationalist. I cannot leave my religion. I'll do everything which helps Sikh. So that from the day he left Congress and he was a total independent of.
And the nationalism was truly there, because when he was speaking for the Sikhs in Punjab and the other minorities, he was also looking up for Bengal. He made speeches because Bengal area was also dominated by a Muslim population, and according to the Muslim League, that any area dominated by a Muslim population should be an independent state. He spoke up for them too, didn't he? Can you tell us a bit more
on what he said? One thing has been established. The latest book, Midnight Furies, has come. A latest book which last month released by a journalist who was news editor of the Newsweek. That Pakistan and India division was accepted by Congress on the basis that Muslim majority will go to Pakistan and non-Muslim to India. By that version, Bengal and Punjab both were Muslim majority state, these were to go to Pakistan. That was the situation. And at that time, the first person in India, Mas Tara Singh started this in 1930. 1930, he started demanding that Punjab should be divided. All along, you read all now correspondence everywhere, he stood for division of Punjab, that half of Punjab Pakistan, other half to India. And for that, he went to Bengal. He motivated Bengal leaders that you also demand division of Bengal. And that became a giant front. And these efforts, because one thing is clear these days, the Britishers tried to help Pakistan. Britishers motivated Mas Tara Singh to have some meeting with Mr. Jinnah. That meeting took place at Malik Arjit Singh's house in Delhi, where Jinnah and Mas Tara Singh met twice. Malik Arjit Singh has given, before his death, complete record of this. Jinnah gave a blank paper to Mas Tara Singh that the Sikhs should accept Pakistan, I give you anything you want. At that time, Malik Arjit Singh wrote that Mas Tara Singh put certain question. He wanted to give us constitutional powers, give us self-determination right. Jinnah said, no, what I write, it is a law. Master said, when you die, who will believe in? He said, no, I am the father of Pakistan. What I convey, it will be you. So there the talks broke, and Mas Tara Singh didn't side with Pakistan. British officer tried their best that somehow Sikhs should join Pakistan, and if this would have happened, whole of Punjab would have gone to Pakistan, and the border would have been Gurgaon. But Mas Tara Singh was the soul. When the Shimla conference took place, Wavell, there were three people, Congress, Nehru, and his colleague Maulana Azad, Jinnah, and Mas Tara Singh. At first time, a Sikh leader was accepted as a third party to take decision on the partition. So there Mas Tara Singh said, I want Azad Punjab, give me, or even give me Sikh state in any form, but something separate. They refused. But there then he convinced them that Punjab be divided. Mas Tara Singh wrote, I know that Sikhs were not majority numerically anywhere in Punjab. We cannot get even a district as a Sikh district. My only these proposals were a threat so that I should convince Britisher to give me something. And that helped me that they agreed for the division of this. And so the division took place. Total, entirely, Aam Akali Party led by Mas Tara Singh, and in Bengal, half. That was the real gift to India. You see, one thing I want to just add. When Maharaja Ranjit Singh came king, remember it, India's boundary was River Sindh for centuries. Yeah. For centuries, Sindh was the boundary, and that boundary was broken to Khyber by Maharaja Ranjit Singh. The whole of NWP came to India first time in history because of the Sikh Raja. And this is the second time the half Punjab came to India because of Maharaja. So these are our two contributions. So this is the Dvian Punjab. But now there are so many my friends in Punjab, new groups, accusing Mas Tara Singh.
Yeah.
That so a Sikh state was available and he didn't get it. He sold Sikh rights to Baldev Singh. For Baldev Singh leadership, he sold Punjab. And all Mr. Sharma is a parliamentarian here. Lord Sahib Suri is there. Read all the papers, British. Not even one line anywhere written that British offered Sikhs a separate state or anything like that in India. In none of the papers it's mentioned. But people say it was available. Mahatma Singh didn't accept it. So
India was created.
But he said he went with the Hindus because he was a born Hindu. So ultimately he remained a Hindu. That's why he took Sikhs to this. So this is, he did it in our interest. You remember, just remember hypothetically, if we were in Pakistan, what happened to Bengalis? What Bengalis happened? How Bangladesh came out? The Muslims couldn't stay. Could we tolerate this treatment in Pakistan? So it was India only, where we can fight, we can do this and that, we can have many demands, but we are one. India and Sikh are one. Whatever may come, we may demand anything, but within India. So that, Mastara Singh laid the foundation. He never said anything against India. He said, I'm against the political party, not against India. We can be against the ruling party, not against the country. So that is the difference. Here people forget sometimes that ruling party opposition and the country's opposition. So these, he laid these, and after
and
that
the principle he stayed committed to.
One thing add more. Because I'm taking advantage of Mr. Sharma sitting here. Two people have been betrayed by India. Two people. Sheikh Abdullah and Mastaras. Sheikh Abdullah saved Srinagar in 1948. Otherwise, Kashmir would have gone to Pakistan. One man who saved Sheikh Abdullah. And what happened to him? Like Mastara Singh, he was put in jail. So what India did to these two stalwarts who gave everything to India? So both of them were betrayed. And India, main toh kehta na, rin chukao. Let us all pray. Now at least the new government should think of to repay to the leaders now who are no more. That what they did, that's what Bajpayee told on that day. I'm leaving this, putting photograph here to pay my tribute to the role of Mastara Singh. Sorry.
That's okay. I think you know, we're trying to work to a time schedule. Just quickly, because we just want to run through his achievements now. I mean, I think time is running short.
I'm failing. She's a good teacher, questioning, and a student, I'm failing.
No. So India was created, and then Masterji played the role he had already begun to play prior to the partition was the resettlement of the, you know, the migrants, because there was a huge migration process which took place. I mean, a lot of people died, but huge numbers came over. And Masterji was very, very important in organizing the resettlement plans. Can you just tell us?
5 lakh people died in partition. And how much destruction and 3 to 4 million people migrated. The biggest tragedy of that period in the world. Settlement of those in India and in Pakistan was the biggest problem. So everybody, not only Mastara Singh, everyone in India then tried his best to help the refugees. Resettlement took 5 and 10 years, but one thing good, that we came out of ashes. Punjabis themselves, you see, stood that we regained within a few years. And everywhere in India, Punjabis flourished out of ashes. That is our effort giant. Here, not Masterji alone, all the governments in India, all the people of this side of Punjab, they went all out to help us. I am also a refugee. So we know how much help was provided to each and everyone by all people living in India.
And then I guess the next real achievement was the Punjabi Subha. The dust settled, and then the work had to go on. I mean, his vision was very clear. And you know, and then we came to that point because he felt that the commitments made by the Congress government had not been fulfilled.
When he fought with Congress, then he started in 1950 a movement for division of Punjab, a smaller state where Sikh majority. It is a long battle, which ultimately before his death, he won it. In 1966, 1st November, the Punjabi Suba came into being, and then he wished well. He was never against any other community. He was only for the rights of his own community and other minority. But gave him credit. So I wrote in Hind Samachar, he selected Lala Jagat Narayan as a member of parliament. Lala Ji was Akali MP sent by Master Tara Singh to parliament. He says he can represent best. So Master Ji used to attend Hindu Mahasabha's conference. One thing more, I told Modi Ji last month, Veer Savarkar was arrested on the death of Mahatma Gandhi, that he is one of those who organized conspiracy. Veer Savarkar is an ideologue who spent 20 years in Kalapani, and perhaps the only one among the Hinduata parties who suffered so much. Master Tara Singh stood by Veer Savarkar. He gave entire money for his lawyers. He organized advocates. He used to sit in the court behind Veer Savarkar. Until Veer Savarkar was released, Master Tara Singh was with him. So that is shows that how much nationalist he was. That Veer Savarkar is the most communalist, which even today the people say. He helped him. He says he's innocent. So that way, Master Tara Singh worked for the goodwill of the community, goodwill of everyone. Never a communalist, what people say to nationalist. When the firing took place in Peshawar on Khan Badshah, Master Ji took a jatha from Amritsar and went to Peshawar to court arrest in favor of the Khan party. So that was his way of working for other communities.
Yeah.
I feel that as we are discussing today, let this message go everywhere, that people should not forget the deeds of those who have done so much for our country. We should be grateful to them. I plead, Modi ji is coming to London, so much is being done. Put one demand, Bharat Ratna to Master Tara Singh. Instead of just demonstrating without any cause, one demand is not a Potwari's demand. It is demand of every Indian who is true Indian, because who saved India at the crisis? Master Tara Singh. So Bharat Ratna, at least be now conferred on him, like has been done on many those who died earlier. That's such a big contribution, and country should pay tribute to his memory, and it will give so much good effect everywhere that I think it's the least we should demand and the government of India should accept.
The passion is running, but there is just one last point which I, you know, do want you to address. Master Ji, you know, being the nationalist, being the fighter, I mean, having the vision and all that, he never actually took on any position. He never took on a ministerial position. He never had any official appointment. He, you know, I mean, that is so very unusual, that the leader that he was, he never considered it necessary to put himself, I mean, he would have got any position he wanted.
So selfless he was. He never became MLA, never became Member of Parliament, and he used to nominate Defence Minister, Chief Minister, Minister, everybody he used to select. And whole of his life, he never accepted any office. He never accepted a penny. He lived in a small room. He lived his life as an ideal life, where people should say, what is called honesty? What is honesty in deeds, honesty in politics, honesty in working? That was the ideal person of his time.
Thank you. I don't think we can add anything more to that. I think that all the adjectives have been used, the words have been used. I now ask...
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Now we'd like to welcome on stage Mr. Jagjit Singh Dardi. Mr. Dardi is son of leading Akali leader freedom fighter. The main aim of Mr. Dardi was to build a TV channel to promote the Indian culture and world heritage on an international stage.
He has travelled from India this evening with his team to cover the event. He will be sharing some of his personal memories of Master Tara Singh.
I must congratulate Potohar Association London for organizing such a nice evening in the memory of late Sardar B.M. Singh Ji and a memorial lecture on Master Tara Singh Ji, because this is the only association on the earth who has done such an excellent job. Moreover, Sardar Darlochan Singh, who is a product of Master Tara Singh and a true Sikh Potohari and the only person on the earth who has been able to narrate the true and correct narrations regarding Master Tara Singh Ji. Now, as far as myself is concerned, I am also a product of Master Tara Singh Ji. And due to the blessings of Master Ji, Sardar Darlochan Singh has been able to achieve the top positions in India, from President's House to the Parliament. And due to the blessings of that great man, I was also able to start a Punjabi daily newspaper, Chardhi Kala, when he was alive in 1966, and I am running that newspapers for last 50 years regularly in India. And due to the blessings of Master Ji, I became the director of world's largest body of print media in 1988. I am colleague of Times of India, Indian Express, Hindustan Times, India Today, or any big newspaper you can name in India. Due to the blessings of Master Ji, I became the accredited journalist of the Parliament of India in 1995, and I got 3 seats, one in Lok Sabha, one in Raj Sabha Press Gallery, and one in Central Hall in 95. And in 98, due to the blessings of that great man, I became the member of the Press Advisory Committee of the Lok Sabha, and now I am member of the Media Advisory Committee of the Rajya Sabha. I am in the Parliament Press Gallery for the last 20 years regularly. Now I have got the status of Veteran Journalist of India by the Parliament of India. And such a foresighted leader of the Sikhs blessed me, and I became the member of the Press Council of India in the year 2001. And till date, I am member of Prime Minister of India, India's media delegation since 1993. I have gone with all the prime ministers during last these years, about 23 years around the globe. As you are celebrating the memory of great Sikh leader Master Tara Singh, I have heard his dozens of speeches. As he has been speaking in Potohari, I would like to narrate something in Potohari language, if you allow me. प्यारी साथ संगत जी, मास्टर जी जदू बोलने से मैं उन्होंने लैक्चर बचपन तो सुनना आया तो सब तो पहला वो बड़े प्यार नाल बड़ी उच्ची आवाज़ विच फतेह गजाने से तुस भी सारे फतेह गजाओ वाहिगुरु जी का खालसा। मास्टर जी की शख्सियत कितनी कमाल नहीं सी। मास्टर जी की जबान विच निकलिया एक एक लफज हर सुनने वाले की किस तरह प्रभावित करना सा उसने दिले विच वसी जाना सा इसका क्या कारण सा। इसका कारण सा मास्टर जी सच्चे सुचे सिख से। मास्टर जी ने कितना उच्चा जीवन सा जे तुस देखो तो तुस हैरान हो सो। मिगी इस गल ना मान के माड़े दादा जी चौधरी साधु सिंह से उन्होंने दादा जी चौधरी बुद्ध सिंह से चौधरी बुद्ध सिंह जी महाराजा रणजीत सिंह नाल उस वेले से जदों महाराजा अटक दरिया पार करन लग्या तो जा पानी बड़ा तेजी नाल चलना पिया सा। पानी इन्ना तेज सा जे सिख फौज अटक दरिया की पार करनी सी ते फौजी तीलियां वंगर रुड़ी जाने से। चौधरी बुद्ध सिंह जी बाबा साहब सिंह जी बेदी सोडी कान सिंह जी ये सारे पठवारी से। बेदी साहब सिंह जी कौटे तो कोई 12 मील दूर किले विच रहने से। इस तरह सोडी कान सिंह जी भी पठवारी से और तहसील कौटा विच किधर रहने से। ये सारे महापुरश जदों महाराजा मुहिम पर जाना सा अदू सारे नाल होने से तो माड़े वड्डे दादा जी नाल से। तो उन्होंने देखा कि महाराजा दुचित्ती विच पई गया हुण कै करिए। उन्होंने आख्या रणजीत सिंह तू गुरु ना सिख है तू अरदास कर। ये दरिया रुकी जासी और इतिहास इस गल ना गवाह कि जदों अरदास होई दरिया हौली होई गया और सिख फौज जिहड़ी दरिया ने परले पासे घिरी होई सी वो सारी महाराजे बचाई आंदी। ते पठवारी कौटे ने चौधरी बुद्ध सिंह जी उस वेले महाराजे ने नाल से। मैं उस चौधरी बुद्ध सिंह ना फरजंद हाँ चौधरी साधु सिंह ना मैं फरजंद हाँ जेड़े पठवारनी दुनिया की सब तो इंपॉर्टेंट तहसील हूँ है कौटा क्योंकि पाकिस्तान उत्थे एटम बम बनाया इस करके कौटा मशहूर आ सारी दुनिया में। तो माड़े दादा जी उस तहसील ने ऑनरेरी मैजिस्ट्रेट से। ये कौटा तहसील रावलपिंडी दियां चार तहसीलों विचों एक सी। कौटा गुजर खान मरी ते रावलपिंडी इटसैल्फ पर पोठवार इलाका जेलम तक लगना सा। गुजरात ना थोड़ा जहा हिस्सा भी पोठवार आना सा। कैमलपुर ना हिस्सा भी थोड़ा जहा दौलताला ते होर इलाके ये भी पठवार आने से। उधरों पठवार पंजा साहब तक जिस तरह सा त्रिलोचन सिंह ने आख्या टैक्सला पंजा साहब नहीं निड़ाया ये पठवार सारा धनी इसकी आखने से। तो मिगी इस गल की खुशी है कि साढ़े परिवार विचों चौधरी चंचल सिंह होर वो कम करी के दसिया जड़ा अज तक कोई नहीं करी सकया। ये पठवार एसोसीएशन ते अज सरदार त्रिलोचन सिंह वालों किया है भाषण। मैं तुसा की दसना चाहना कि मैं एक टीवी चैनल इंडिया तू चलाना जड़ा हिंदुस्तान ने 30 करोड़ घर अवेलेबल है। 30 करोड़ घर लोग हिंदुस्तान विच चढ़दी कला टाइम टीवी की देख ही सकने। और मैं पिछले 10 सालों तो मैं भी पठवारी पुत्र हाँ कौटे ना जाया होया। ते मैं तुसंगी दसना चाहना कि ये महाराजा रणजीत सिंह तो बाद सिखा की गिनती 10-15 लाख रही गई सी। और ये जिन्होंने संत दत्तर सिंह जी गल त्रिलोचन सिंह ने की है ये संत त्रिलोचन सिंह जी ये संत दत्तर सिंह जी सन 1995 ने नेड़े कौटे आए से। और जड़ी सिखा ने ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन हुई सिखा ने जागृति हुई ये सारी घोटे तो शुरू हुई सी, ये पठवार तो शुरू हुई सी। ते पहला जड़ा अमृत प्रचार संतां कीता सा वो भी घोटे विच कीता सा। ते मस्तुआनियो संत अतर सिंह जी पैदल घोटे आए से, घोटा तहसील विच संतां ना पीरियड जड़ा आया रहने ना वो पौने तीन साल ने करीब आ। और तुसां की खुशी हो सी कि मास्टर तारा सिंह होर भी घोटे तहसील विच अमृत छकिया, घोटे शहर तो 10 मील ने करीब चोआ खालसा थोआ खालसा से, थोआ खालसा विच उन्हां संतां कोलों अमृत छकिया सा। ये बड़ी माण वाली गल ही कि मास्टर तारा सिंह उत्थे अमृत छकिया, उत्थों तैयार बार तैयार होए और 50 साल तो ही ज़्यादा समा उन्होंने खालसा पंथ की सेवा ना लीडरी तो उन्हें की 40-45 साल सेवा की उन्होंने बहुत लंबा समा, क्योंकि उन्होंने अमृत छकने का जोड़ा पीरियड आ वो 1997 ने करीब आ 18 साल ने से, इसका मतलब 2000 ने नेड़ा उन्हें अमृत छकया सा। सो मैं ज़्यादा कुछ ना कहना, मैं तो इस गल खुशी दसदा तुसें कि मैं तो तरलोचन सिंह रली का काम कर सो काम कर सड़ा सरदार तरलोचन सिंह ने सुपना सा। तरलोचन सिंह साड़ी कौम में इको एक बंदा जिसने एक नवा इतिहास बनाया और पठवार ने ना उच्चा किया और वो काम किया जड़ा कोई नहीं करी सकना। सा तरलोचन सिंह की शख्सियत, सरदार तरलोचन सिंह की विविधता, सरदार तरलोचन सिंह ने गुण सारे के असा की उस उपर माण है। और मैं तुसांगी दसना मैं इन्होंने बच्चा बनी क्या सारी उम्र काम किया बड़ा लम्मा समा, क्योंकि माड़े पापा जी सा तरलोचन सिंह ने दोस्त से 1951-52 तो मैं इन्होंने काम किया 60 साल तो ज़्यादा। हूँ पार्लीमेंट में भी मैं इन्होंने नाल बैठना और मैं क्योंकि वाहगुरु ने बड़ी कृपा ही मेरा TV सारी दुनिया के लोग देखने और मेरा अखबार भी लखा लोग पढ़ने। तो जो गल इन्हें आखी कि असा मास्टर जी की भारत रत्न दवा सा, असा इन्हों नाल प्लैनिंग कर सा, कोशिश कर सा, आवाज़ उठा सा अपने मीडिया राही TV चैनल राही, जो कुछ मैं करी सकिया मैं कर सा। और मैं तुसा की बधाई भी देना कि तुसा वो काम किया जो दुनिया च कोई नहीं करी सकिया। और चंचल सिंह जी चौधरी असा ना अपना परिवार और इन्हें असा साडे खानदान ना ना उच्चा किया, मैं बहुत बहुत मुबारक देना और मैं तरलोचन सिंह की बधाई भी देना। तो मैं हूँ सारे की कह हाँ सारे को मैं आस करना तुम माड़े सिर उपर हाथ रखो, मैं भी वो काम करीगा दसा सा तरलोचन सिंह उन्होंने मिली गया जरा तुसा ना सुपना है। वाहगुरु जी का खालसा वाहगुरु जी की फतह।
वी वुड नाउ लाइक टू अनाउंस फॉर काउंसलर जसबीर आनंद टू जॉइन अस ऑन स्टेज फॉर द अवार्ड सेक्शन ऑफ द इवनिंग।
माय लॉर्ड्स, लेडीज, ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट, फ्रेंड्स, अ वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। My name is Jasbir Kaur Anand and I'm the Vice President of our brotherhood. It is my utmost pleasure to be part of the memorial event in the memory of Master Tara Singh Ji. This evening, I would like to share my thoughts on how we can engage and persuade our young people to be part of the Puthwar Association. We need to build a strong society. We need to ensure that all generations have a stake and a voice. In Britain, we are increasingly running the risk of being in a position where our young people's prospects are looking worse than their parents' generation. They are priced out of work, higher education, and housing, and increasingly reliant on help from older generations. Also, more importantly, I believe young people feel they don't have a voice in making decisions that affect them. We have seen this at the recent general election, that turnout amongst young people was half that of people of retirement age. And I'm sure that Rinder Bhaji sitting in the audience today will agree with what I have just said. But we at the Puthwar Association have worked hard to ensure
local young people have the means to express themselves on issues that concern them, whether it is for the embetterment of the Baradri or their general concerns of daily issues. We have had success on issues of gender equality, bringing together young and older women. We also have a youth subcommittee which is being strengthened with the support of our elders. Our president, Mr. Pushpinder Singh Khanpur, with his committee, are keen to continue the progress of getting our youth involved at all times. Well, to achieve success, we must work together towards our aims. We're asking parents today to take the initiative to involve and send their young ones to take interest in our Baradri affairs. And I think a few questions were raised today, and we're happy to take on board those questions after the memorial event. We really do need new blood to come in and move the Baradri into the future with a huge enthusiasm. Well, living in the 21st century means internet is broken down, the international barriers of education, achievement, and of course, the causes of aspiration. In this day and age, any child, regardless of social background, anywhere in the world, can aspire to become CEOs, directors of firms, or as in case of Narendra Modi, becoming Prime Minister of India. Well, this is the spirit we need to harness. I'm very fortunate to be part of the executive committee who has the foresight, courage, and wisdom to initiate such change. Tonight, we are paying tribute to late Mr. B.M. Singh, who has always been a tremendous support to the community. We have learned a lot from his ethics and his generosity. And in time, I'm very sure that we will carry on his legacy. Friends, tonight, we are honoring six young British Potawaris who have done well in their respective fields, and we're very sure they will progress further in their lives to achieve the best. It is now my pleasure to ask Lord Suri and Indraneel Singh, the grandson of Mr. B.M. Singh, to come to the stage for giving the awards. I will also request both Vani Chaudhary and Donny Soni to read the citations of our awardees. And now in the end, I just would like to say that Harry Truman once said that it is amazing what you can accomplish if you do not care who gets the credit. So that is a huge thought in our minds today. And if we can think about that a little bit and reflect on what I've just said. Thank you, and good luck to all the awardees tonight. Thank you, boys.
Thank you very much. We would really appreciate it if there could be some silence during the award ceremony so the awardees would have all the respect they deserve tonight for winning these esteemed awards. First of all, we'd like to invite Mr. Ramanjit Singh Arora to stage. He is the director of HSBC Global Banking and Markets Traded Risk. He had led various regulatory initiatives at Credit Suisse, RBS, and Barclays.
He is mentoring students at London's George Green School to help them prepare for a future career in the corporate world.
We'd now like to call Mr. Sarbjit Singh Bakshi, who worked for the Government Digital Service in the Cabinet Office. And through his work and the work of his team, saved the government £1.7 billion last financial year.
Previously, he has worked for UK Trade and Investment, supporting trade ministers and UK companies break into emerging markets all around the world.
Now, We'd now like to invite Mr. Vivek Chadda, who is a franchisee, operator, owner, and developer of multiple hotels across the UK. He has acquired more than 8 hotels in less than 2 years.
He currently franchises mainly with IHG and Accor. He is currently developing a 300-bedroom hotel at London Heathrow.
Now we'd like to welcome Dr. Pooja Dasan Chahal. Dr. Pooja is a consultant neurologist working at Ealing Hospital and Imperial College Healthcare NHS Trust. She has recently been appointed clinical lead of neurology across 3 hospital trusts.
She runs a specialist clinic at Queen Charlotte's Hospital, where she works with pregnant women with complex neurological problems.
Now we'd like to welcome Mr. Amandeep Kalar, who is a senior British diplomat and deputy investment commissioner delegate.
He will be based in Delhi from December 2015 and have a cross India remit promoting the bilateral UK-India investment relationship. He has spent much of his career working on international security issues.
He has also kindly flown in from India to be with us this evening, so please give him another round of applause for his dedication.
Sorry, I know it's been a long night, so I won't take up too much of your time. I am just about to go out to Delhi to be a Deputy High Commissioner for the British government with my family. And I'm really struck. There are now 3 of us, so 3 out of 9 current British Deputy High Commissioners in India are now second generation Indians. And that's a very, very interesting dynamic in the sense that yourselves, many of the distinguished people here tonight are born and raised in India, and we've heard with the great passion with which they speak of their time in India, Master Dara Singh and a number of other individuals of whom we should be proud. But it's now incumbent on the second generation, particularly as it's a very interesting and it's a very key thing as second generation Indians for us to go back and actually work with the country itself where you all came. So thank you for all of your time and for this award.
Finally, we'd like to honour Councillor Rena Ranger, who could not be with us this evening. Councillor Ranger started an organisation 3 years ago called Women Empowered, which brings women together to share their experiences and empower each other.
She ran for Three Rivers District Council in 2014 and was elected. She is unable to attend, but we are very proud of her achievements and wish her well. Finally, can we please invite former President Mrs. Jasbir Vora to the stage to give a vote of thanks?
She has made enormous contributions as the only female president of the Potohar Association and has been a role model for many young women. Can we please have a big round of applause?
Welcome, friends. On behalf of President Mr. Pushpinder Singh Kanpur and the Executive Committee of Potohar Bradri, I would like to welcome all of you here. Lord Lumba, who's now not with us at the moment, he's just departed. Lord Suri, Vrinder Singh, that's what I feel like. And all the dignitaries who have made such a big effort to come to London and be part of this association's inaugural lecture. If Finally, on behalf of the Potwar Brothers, I would like to thank the management of Edwardian Radisson Group, Mr. Jaswinder Singh, and his son Inder Neel Singh, who are grandson of Mr. Balminder Singh. Balminder Singh, as it happens, was my brother-in-law. And this venue is courtesy of them that we've had this venue and the drinks and the canapés that we enjoyed earlier on in the evening. An event like this could not have been organized without the efforts and dedication and professional team who have been working with us over the past several weeks. Organizing an event needed careful planning and execution. I am delighted that our dedicated executive, led by our General Secretary Chanchal Singh Chaudhary, big hand to him, was able to deliver on the promise of great evening. Everything ran as planned. No mean feat when you consider the state of the scale of the event and that it was achieved with such limited resources. I would also like to thank both Sukhneel Goel and Mr. Tarlochan Singh. Very, very special thank you to him for having come all the way from India to enlighten us about Master Tara Singh. I have learned so much about this amazing life and contribution to this great statesman and Sikh leader, Master Tara Singh. Thank you for enlightening us. I'm also very pleased to say that the media have made such an effort to be here today. In particular, I am grateful to Mr. Jagjit Singh Dardi, Chardi Kala TV executive, who has specially flown in from India to be with us today. Finally, I would like to thank all of you, and that is a very big thank you, for your generous support and also for giving up your valuable time and to be with us this evening. It is not easy to come into London at the end of a long working day. Seeing you here has made it all worthwhile. Now we're going to present this portrait of B.M. Singh, Balminder Singh, to his grandson. Now, where is he gone?
This is from Potwar Association.
Thank you.
This is a small present from the Potwar Association to the family. I am very, very grateful that they have spent all this time, energy, and given us this beautiful venue so that we could have a very, very special inaugural lecture on Master Tara Singh, which was so, so important to all of us and all of our young people who are going to learn about it in the future. Thank you. Drive carefully, safe home.